Hi everybody, and welcome back to Greater Manchester Stories. This episode's amazing guest is a gentleman I met last year, Jason Hargreaves, who runs a political group called Lee and Atherton Independents. So first of all, welcome to the show.
Thanks, Nick.
Let's get straight into it. So Lee and Atherton Independents, why did you set it up? Why was it needed? Let's talk about that for a moment.
Well, I stood as an independent in the 2007 local election, and I noticed it was hard being on your own, even though I wanted to do things without a political party, without having people able to help you go out and leave work, it's very hard. So I spoke to a few other people who were wanting to stand independently, and we set up a group. The group, we pool all our resources. So we'll set up, I'll go to their ward, they go to my ward, we'll go to other people's wards. But we all stand on our own beliefs. So I have no say in someone else's belief. If they are against the development and I'm for it, that's how it is. That's what's different. So the idea was to have a group that could represent the local people in each and every ward on the eastern half of Wigan, because quite frankly, we are neglected. And that's why we set up Lee and Atherton Independents.
No, I that's a great philosophy you've got there, that you can work with other independents, even if you disagree on issues. And that for me is the way forward, because what's really killing this country is the party whip, meaning if you're a Labour MP or a Tory or a Lib Dem, so all the parties are the same, even Reform, they're all the same. If you stand for them and you become elected, your freedom to say and do what you want then disappears. You have to do what the party tells you to do. Otherwise, they say to you, you won't be standing for us again. We're going to deselect you and you won't stand for us again. It's blackmail, and it's how the parties keep their power.
Exactly. Like, you spoke to one of our team, I think it was Friday, in Richard, and it's the pure example. I have disagreements with a number of our people over how things are being done. Like, I would love a landlord registry. Some of them don't like it. Some of them think it's a great idea. But we're still working as a team. We still go out, support each other. And if we see something, we pass it on to them and say, there's something there in your area that we may need looking after.
No, and that's a great point about not having to agree with each other. Because to be perfectly frank, it doesn't matter if you agree with me or not, because the only people who are responsible for making those decisions are called the voter. And if the voter agrees with me, they'll vote for me. So your opinion on my policies are irrelevant, because you only have one vote. If I can attract more votes, that means my policies were the right policies for my area. We need local people standing in local areas, addressing the needs of local people. What we don't need is anybody higher up, anybody from a different area saying, nope, you're doing it the wrong way. No, no, no. In local areas, we need local people dictating what they want in their area.
Yeah, I fully agree. As I said, I've been in national parties. I've worked with an MP in London. I went out canvassing for him, door knocking, leafleting. And he always had to stick to this script of what he could say and what he couldn't say. And that's not what I'm about. I'm quite a straight-talking guy. If I don't like something, I say it. I upset people. I know I do. It's never meant to be upsetting to someone, but I don't give a bit of BS. I don't say something just to get your vote. If I'm talking to you about something, then that's what I believe. It's not, oh, I'll say this, get my vote, and then I'll go to the next door and say something completely different.
Yeah, I mean, how many politicians do that? I mean, let's talk about Keir Starmer. on Remembrance Day at one press conference. He had a poppy on. Then he's talking to a Muslim group, no poppy on. The politicians do this all the time. And that's why we get the phrase, politicians will tell you what you want to hear. And they'll tell the next person what they want to hear. I'm very much like you. I say it the way it is. And it's not that I don't care. If I had to be truthful, I don't want you voting for me under a misunderstanding. I want you to vote for me because you know what I mean and what I say and what I'm going to do. I don't want you to vote for me by mistake and then get disappointed a year down the line going, oh, he isn't what I thought he was. I thought he was going to fix this and fix that. Well, no, I'll tell you what I'm going to do. And if you don't like it, then don't vote for me because this wishy-washy politics we're always playing is damaging the voter and it's damaging trust in our political system. And that's why we're in the mess we're in today.
Yeah, I fully agree. One of the things I've noticed when I speak to people on the door, they always go, you're the same. They're so used to the fact that politicians will, excuse the language, but bullshit them. And the apathy for politicians is so low. Most people don't trust anyone who stands. And I can understand it. As a voter myself, I listen to what our MPs and our mayor's going to say and do and all this. And frankly, I don't believe a lot of it. I think they're all talking out their arse in that regards. So my view is we need honest politicians. We need, I would like to say statesman. You know, who's going to say, I believe this, I'm going to do it. It may not work, but I'm going to try. And then go, you know what? I messed up. And be honest about it when we mess up, because that is the only way we will gain trust, is to admit if we mess up, if we've got something wrong, we go, yeah, I've got that wrong. Please forgive me. I will try do better. And unfortunately, not one politician, unless they're forced to, will ever issue an apology.
No, they absolutely don't. So let's talk about you. Let's talk about you standing for council in Leigh South Ward. What are your issues? Let's name your top three issues. So let's start with number one. What's the main issue in your ward?
Number one is lack of infrastructure, road infrastructure. We've got three main roads causing through Leigh South. We've got St Helens Road, which goes from Leigh Bus Station all the way down to Adderley Way. Then we've got Warrington Road, which goes from Canal Turn, Butts Bridge, all the way down to the Greyhound on the East Lancs. And then we've got Manchester Road, which goes from Green Lane Chippy, anyone local will know it, all the way down to Astley and comes out on East Lancs Road again by the Texaco Garage. Now, these are rammed pretty much from 7 o'clock to 10 o'clock. You know, these three roads, there's no route out, there's houses built and built and built and built. That'll actually take me on to the second problem we have.
Well, before we move on, so what are your solutions for that problem?
My solutions is a proper road infrastructure survey, looking at where we can improve the road, where we can take traffic away from these main course throughs. Because unfortunately, by having these just three roads, all of them one lane ways each way, there's not enough capacity. The roads are logged, they're jammed. You know, you have residents where cars are just sitting there and the right hand side, the homes pumping out fumes. Now, I'm not one for CAS or that. I think it's a terrible idea. But it seems that these roads are being are designed to make sure that traffic stopped. There's nothing looking like it's going to take it away, make it easier to get onto the Lancs to go either way, either to go to Liverpool or go to Manchester. There's nothing that seems to be done. Or even going to Warrington, Adderley Way was meant to go straight through to Warrington. Unfortunately, he hasn't. So that's another issue.
So you want a full evaluation of the road network in your ward and try to work out why we have these problems. Are they inflicted upon the ward on purpose to get you out of your car, or is it incompetence, or do we need a better system? So I like that plan. So number two, what's your second priority?
Number two is right on the border of Lee South. They're planning on putting more homes. They're doing Upper Astley at the Manchester Road end. They're doing it in the Lowton end as you come over Atherley Way. There's plans for more homes. And there's also plans for like an enterprise zone where buildings, they're going to go onto Greenbelt. So it's just adding more traffic to the area, adding more problems. So the lack of foresight, we're in places for everyone, which is a Greater Manchester wide housing boom and bust type thing. Wigan Council should have literally gone, we don't want to be in that. We will set our own plan based off using brownfield sites, looking at disused land which has previously been, used or have rewilded. Great, sometimes rewilding is brilliant because you're like at Bears Lane, there's a nice old colliery that's just in Lee West now. Nice old colliery, it's now wilded, backs onto the cow, you've got doe. You've got bats and everything. So it's a great thing there. However, we've got brownfields which could be used. We've got old mills that could be used for homes and that. So we need to look at how we build the homes rather than just go, okay, we're going to build a load, we're going to take green space, and we're not going to look at anything else. We need an overhaul.
We do. I think most councils, but especially Wigan Council, which still has some lovely area in Wigan, don't become Manchester where it's just a concrete jungle. Wigan needs to keep its green spaces, and Wigan Council need to put out a policy which says, if you put planning permission in, we reject all planning permission on greenfield sites, and just tell the developer straight away. There's no point even looking at it because it will be a no from us. That will then force them start looking at brownfield sites, and it's like, and it is more expensive to build on brownfield sites. But do you know what? That's a price we're going to have to pay to keep our greenfield sites. We cannot concrete over the whole country and the whole region to build more houses because there is a housing shortage. I get that. Well, first of all, let's stop immigration. That will help the housing shortage. But as a mayor and as a councillor, we can't do that. But let's stop destroying our countryside where there's other solutions for this. So I like number two. Not many people are brave enough to be doing number two because you can make some money building houses. Politicians can become quite famous and get a lot of support if you're handing out planning permission. So what's your third priority?
The third one is something that harks back to a little boy we sadly lost through to council conditions in his home. The council here tend to lack the foresight, or they're incompetent with black mould. We have residents constantly fighting to get their houses sorted. We have residents not getting safety checks done, and it does seem to me that the council are just like, yeah, we'll just keep building, we won't worry, and residents are suffering. I lived in a property only 4 years ago, black mould. I spoke to the councillors, I spoke to the landlord, and I spoke to the council themselves, and I said, we're struggling. My missus has asthma. This black mold is a problem. The landlord won't do anything, and they were like, yeah, there's not much we can do. I'm now knocking on tenants' doors, and they're showing me mold. There's a woman, she's got two kids with learning difficulties, one with severe ADHD, And he stuck was stuck in a room for 12 months with black mold. The windows were broke, not the window frames themselves, the sealants were broke. It took 12 months for the council to actually even start to do anything. When they'd done it, they just painted over the mold. Rather than they treated it, but then just painted over the mold. Rather than getting to the source, seeing what was wrong, turns out there was leakage on one of the gutterings, which went into the bricks, caused problems.
There's an easy solution for this. First of all, you're correct. The standard of our homes are declining, especially rented homes, and that's because of the housing shortage. So people will put up with a worse service now, thinking, well, there's nothing else out there, and I don't want to upset my landlord in case he kicks me out, so I better shut up. And that's a big issue across the country, but especially Greater Manchester. There's a simple solution for this. It's not the council, it's one piece of legislation. If we passed a piece of legislation that gave tenants the power to reclaim back the rent for houses that are not fit to live in, and we open that up to the private sector, so basically no win, no fee solicitors, and we allowed them to inspect a home and then claim the money back off the council, the housing association, of a private landlord, and then the no win, no fee will be we keep half the money and you get half the money. Over the first year, almost every home in Greater Manchester will be brought up to decent standards because they will be able to claim back. You can imagine claiming back 10 years' rent off your landlord because your house isn't fit for purpose. That one piece of legislation will solve this problem overnight because the council are incompetent, don't have the money, don't have the staff, no one cares. Housing associations, many of them are incompetent as well because they've still got that council mentality. Let's open it up to solicitors to start suing people and claiming the rent back. Things will improve overnight.
This is where I actually think a lot along the lines, what I think a landlord register would be good. Renters could then see who are the slumdog landlords and who are the good landlords, both council and private. It would show how things can change. We can improve things at a local level. As a mayor, you could actually provide a Greater Manchester landlord register, which would improve each borough. And I think these are the things we need to do at a local level. We don't always need national parties getting their noses in it. And quite a lot of the time, when national parties get their noses in local issues, they mess them up. You only have to look at the B network. As much as I'm glad that buses are or should be under public ownership, I do feel the B network has been done wrong. It's franchised. It's no better than the rail. So when national parties get involved, I feel they ignore the local people.
Oh, they do, because they're looking at a national level. And what's good in Coventry, what's good in Edinburgh, what's good in Salford isn't necessarily good for Lee South. You can't have this broad brush stroke across the country thinking this will improve every area. Local areas have different issues, different infrastructure, different people, different aspirations, different history. And all that has to be taken into account. And the only people who can take that into account seriously are called local people because they know what's best for them. And let's say local people make a mistake and it turns out they didn't know best. Well, that's okay because local people then can change. Local people can correct their mistake. But how do you correct a mistake that was made at 10 Downing Street? You have no power to correct that mistake. So give the power to local people. They'll make better decisions, and if they make mistakes, they'll correct them over time. So spot on. Jason, thank you much for coming on. For people who live in Lee South, the description of this video will have Jason's details if you want to contact him, if you want to ask questions, if you want to get involved. And if you live in Lee South, here's a gentleman that you need to be seriously looking at to vote for. So cheers, Jason, and I'll speak to you soon.
Thanks, X. See you later.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
If you like that video, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, hit that notification bell, and comment. And if you like what I'm saying about running for Mayor of Greater Manchester, then stick around. Tell your family, tell your friends. It's the only way I'm going to have a chance of winning is a grassroots movement. So be part of that movement and hit that bell. Thanks.